David Ellam from Silence Therapeutics joins me now on Skype. David, good afternoon. Nice to catch up with you.
Good afternoon, Andrew. Nice to meet you.
And you, David. A busy 6 months it's been for you. Your interim's out today. And RNAi, excitement continuing to build around that as a therapeutic platform.
Absolutely, yes. And there have been a lot of developments both for Silence so far this year and then also within the RNA industry as a whole this year and for the rest of 2017. I think for Silence, we can now say that our GalNAc platform is up and running and is competitive with the other companies in the field. We are developing our pipeline. We have a number of products on our website. You can see as we're gradually sort of moving those across. We have filed a number of innovative patents during 2017, sort of in new technological areas. And we are focusing a lot on target selection, because as a management team, we believe that that actually is where we can get the edge when you think that there are a number of other companies that do have similar, very similar platforms, very similar performance. So actually picking the right targets is key. And then we've already announced that towards the end of 2017, November the 14th, we're going to have a capital markets day, sort of like an R&D day where we'll be releasing data. So for us, all of those things are a big step forward. But we're very excited as well at the state of the industry as a whole. So Alnylam, who are the largest company in the siRNA field, they have announced that sometime probably later in September, they will give the initial readout from their patisiran TTR drug trial, which if that is good, and if they then go ahead and file and are approved, that will be the first short interfering RNAi drug anywhere in the world. They've also started another phase 3 study, patisiran this year, and then givisiran, yet another one, both of these latter two with the GalNAc technology. Those are all due for starting a phase 3 this year as well. Arrowhead, they have a R&D day coming up shortly in September. And then Dicerna, who are the other company, they've already announced that they intend to have an IND application filed and possibly even getting close to be in man by the end of 2017. So it's gone from being sort of a little bit quiet for a little while to this whole new therapeutic modality. And hopefully there will be a number of drugs available, new drugs for patients, often in areas of high unmet need. And that's certainly where we're looking to focus our efforts as well.
Plenty of things to pick up on in what you've just been mentioning, David. One of them being, you say Alnylam. They're one of the companies you're chasing for intellectual property infringement. Is that correct?
Yes. So back in early July, we issued a claim of notice. We haven't filed that yet, and we have a time frame to file that in. And I know that my colleague Ali Mortazavi, when he's spoken with you previously, has sort of scoped out that we are duty bound to protect our intellectual property. We have our own in-house head of IP. We've spoken with external firms, got all the facts together. So we're fairly sure about what we're doing, and we are planning to go through the legal courses. But again, as he had said previously, a handshake is often the best way to go in these things, and nobody really wants to go all the way. But we feel it's a great opportunity for Silence and for our shareholders.
How many companies do you suspect have overstepped the mark when it comes to infringing the IP here?
Well, I think we're just focusing on the two companies noted within our press releases, which is Alnylam and then the medicines company who have licensed inclisiran from them. And inclisiran is another product that is very close to starting a phase 3.
Very good. David, you also, just taking a step back, you mentioned the GalNAc platform. You're intending to file an application there. What does the platform do in a nutshell?
So the technology to silence a gene or the knowledge to do that has been there since around the turn of the century, I think, which was where there was a Nobel Prize given for that discovery. The key has always been the delivery of the silencing molecule to wherever you want it to go in the body. And certainly Silence and a lot of other companies had trouble achieving that. And then there was gradual work done that discovered that GalNAc, which is a sugar or a carbohydrate, if you can attach through a linker your silenced molecule to the GalNAc, GalNAc actually will attach to the hepatocytes in the liver really easily, and then express that gene through into the liver really easily. So it's kind of somebody discovered through time, and there's total freedom to operate over GalNAc, I should say. It's nobody's owned invention, that it just works really well.
And you're intending to file an application by the end of next year, are you?
So that's the reference in our interims to filing an IND application by the end of 2018. So that will be for one of the drugs in our pipeline. We haven't disclosed which one yet. And that will be when we've completed all the various preclinical work and manufacturing type work that you have to do in order to make an application to the authorities to say, we would like to test this in people now.
Well, incredibly exciting, as you say, the last couple of months being this huge build-up, I suppose, where your market cap's concerned, at least, almost doubling. Are you putting this down to the buzz around RNAi and the excitement, the build-up?
Yes. I mean, it's obviously difficult to always say, but yes, I think the industry is up. There's a lot of awareness in the industry. So Arrowhead shares not that long ago were down around $1.50. They're up around $3 now. Dicerna shares have gone up a huge amount, and Alnylam have maintained a high level in the 80s of dollars for quite a long time. So I think, yes, there is a lot of excitement about what may happen, hopefully will happen, with the short interfering RNA in 2017 and going forward.
And going forward, you're continuing to keep an eye on costs, trying to keep a lid on any unnecessary expenditure?
Yes. I mean, I think the cash burn that we have in the first half of this year is comparable with the two halves of 2016. So we're certainly being very cautious. We're at the early stage in some of our work. So obviously, as we then move down the chain and you start doing manufacturing, you start heading towards trials with people in, then it does get more expensive. So we're just concentrating to make sure that we keep our focus on the cost control. And although we're looking at several target genes molecules, we're constantly evaluating through target product profiles mainly, you know, do we want to continue? And if we think it's not going to be commercially viable, if it's not there for the right level of unmet need, or it's not partnerable if we need to partner, then we will pull that one out and then start another one through rather than just waste money on them or continue to spend money on them rather.
And I suppose that indeed is the name of the game, really. That's the point, getting drugs back into people. That's what you're in the business of doing.
Yes, absolutely. And, you know, that I'm sure is a lot of people. That's what gets them up at the beginning of the day. There is wide, you know, all companies. We have a lot of scientists, our R&D hub in Berlin. And, you know, everyone is pushing ahead, working as hard as they can. And that's the aim for the whole company.
David, pleasure to meet you. Nice to catch up. Thanks very much for taking the time.
Andrew, thank you. Goodbye.